Webhooks is a tool that allows you to subscribe to certain events in CVAT. Each event corresponds to a certain set of actions that can happen to your organization and or project. To show you how exactly it works, we've created an organization, set up a test project, and added a task. Now let's inspect the webhooks form. The target URL for webhooks is the web address to which the event's data is sent. Fill in the description field as you please. You can click on the project field to select a project for the webhook. The content type field refers to the HTTP header that specifies the type of data of the webhook request. For security reasons, to be sure that webhooks come from CVAT, you can specify a secret key. You can select if you want to use SSL and choose to disable the delivery of webhook payloads by deselecting active. In the payload, you can receive everything or just selected events. For the sake of this video, we will select two, job and task. To test webhooks, we will use Zapier. Here we've pre-configured it. It will catch a raw webhook call, run a code to extract needed information and forward it to the designated email. In the received payload, complete information about the object associated with this event is available. It will send an email with information about the user who triggered this event, job ID, organization ID, and project ID, what changes were made to the task, and who triggered them. Now let's set up webhooks in CVAT. We are copying the Zapier webhook URL into the target URL field, then enter data in all other fields and click submit. Here is the webhook, now we can test it. To test it, click ping. After we click ping, CVAT sends an event to the configured URL, in our case to Zapier, which is configured to transform the message and send an email to the designated email address. That is what we will get. Now let's imagine you have a team of annotators. You've created a CVAT organization, assigned annotators, and added projects and tasks. What you need now is a better understanding of how things are going, if the annotation of the certain task was finished or not. With webhooks, you will get a notification every time the configured event happens. As I mentioned before, here we want to know whether work on a certain task is accomplished. So we change the task status from in progress to complete. The webhook will be triggered by the event and send the email notification. Here we can see the job, the project, and performed action. As we wrap up this video, note that webhooks have a vast range of applications. You can automate tasks such as sending emails, or even retraining machine learning models when new data is available. However, exploring these applications is beyond this overview. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Happy annotating!